The inaugural Democracy Day lecture was informative. The Director General of the Nigerian Institute of International Affairs, Professor Bola Akinterewa, elaborated on African democratic transitions, Nigeria as a tipping point. You will also get to hear about the dynamics of winning and losing elections in Nigeria and what may soon be known as the Madukwenian theory.
Nigerians have now chosen to change governments, including a government where the power of incumbency gave way to the popular opinion that they wanted a change. We have taken a quantum leap. Elsewhere in Africa, the best that happened was that the ruling party lost election to opposition party, but the serving president did not lose election. He was already on his way out. In our own case, not only are we giving up power as a party, we're also giving power as a president with all the powers of incumbency. A president who was entitled by constitution for a second time. Nigeria said, no, that constitutional prerogative, we determine it. We don't want you again. We want another person. That's a quantum leap. My records show that nowhere else in Africa has that taken place. It's going to be a permanent memory seared in the conscience of all Nigerians. As the world president, Goodluck Jonathan, hand over the baton of office to President Muhammadu Buhari in the tranquil atmosphere of Abuja, and all the doom saying about Nigeria's 100 years of existence will come on stock in 2014-15, that has given way to a new optimism. I therefore seize the opportunity to call on all those who believe that Nigeria is all about oil and gas and then the counter-narrative of Boko Haram to know that a smooth and peaceful political transition has taken place in Nigeria. I take pride to say, even if I may feel a personal loss, that my party has lost the election. But that loss means victory for my country, and that's more important.
The lecture gives the impression that there can be a democratic transition that is peculiar to Africa, because it says African democratic transition. Why not European democratic transition? Why not Latin American democratic transition? Is their own pattern of transition different? Very interesting. In the context of Africa, since we are talking about Africa, we can talk about three or four types. For instance, we had the transition from Umaru Yar'Adua to Ebele Jonathan, but that one was described as a transition on the basis of doctrine of necessity. So, taking over in that case is another form of transition and is still democratic. But it is still different from the transfer of power from Ebele Jonathan to Muhammadu Buhari. While the transfer of power from Olusegun Obasanjo to Umaru Yar'Adua is another manifestation of democratic transition. Both Olusegun Obasanjo and Umaru Yar'Adua belong to the same party, the same PDP. For the first time in the political history, in the electoral history of Nigeria, we are now having a transition in which power moves, all right, not from the loser, according to Ojoma Dwekwe, because in this case, the incumbent does not lose election, actually, but because of the greater interest of the nation, national unity, you allow the opposition to win the election so that the nation can survive. It has never been so. If you want to understand this point I'm making, you can as well easily refer yourself to the current situation in Burundi. I am saying that if Ebele Jonathan conceded defeat, he did not concede defeat on the basis of the number of voters he had or that Muhammadu had. No, that's not my position. The issue is that the election itself had some minor problematics. It is not that Ebele Jonathan did not have the necessary weapons to delay, but he set aside this first option. He took a panoramic view of the whole processes and said, at the end of the day, if I have more votes than the challenger, what is the implication for the future? What is the implication for the future of Nigeria? If he won the election, what would have been the scenarios? At the level of strategic calculations, national unity, territorial integrity, all these factors were reckoned with. So when we now say he accepted defeat, it is not the defeat, it is not the electoral defeat per se, but the need to defeat disunity, the need to sustain Nigeria, and that's where Madwekwenian theory has come into place by saying that it is not the election that was lost,